Some people have love at first sight, and we did not. We didn't.
No.
We actually met each other for the first time twice. I remember the first time very vividly, but I don't remember you.
Same.
I remember interacting with you, but I don't remember what you looked like. I don't remember your personality. I don't remember anything about you. I just remember this figure and then the memory happening. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, except I think I actually remember you better from that time because my friend knew you, and so she told me about you.
And we were good friends at school.
Yes.
And then that was our first introduction. We'll get more into that later, guys. But first, guys, this talk is sponsored by Helix, our backdrop. We love it so much. Last time we did a video here, we were talking about me being a violent sleeper.
But you know what? Since we've gotten this mattress, no joke, I have noticed that you don't do that anymore at all. In fact, I don't even know that you're in the bed with me. You're just sleep like a rock.
Thank you, Helix.
So it must be working.
Helix has saved our marriage. Helix is different than other mattress companies because they have this sleep quiz that they developed that fits you with the perfect mattress. I've talked about this before on this channel. If you haven't done it already, shame on you. Get on it. We've had our Helix mattress for months now, past the 100-night trial, and we absolutely love it. We're never gonna give it away, ever, never, ever. I have gotten so many messages from so many of you out there who have done the sleep quiz and got your perfect mattress, and you are absolutely loving it. One of our friends actually just got one and he's loving it too. We got matched with their very softest mattress, which is great for us, but we even wanted it a little more soft, so we got their mattress topper plush thing. It was incredible.
Great.
Go to helixsleep.com/JordanTaylor, take their sleep quiz, and you'll get up to $200 off your mattress and two free pillows, what we're using now. When you support our sponsor, you are 100% supporting us and this channel, so thank you so much.
And we really appreciate it.
Let's get back to how we met. I think it's funny that we both have the same memory of a non-memory about the first time that I almost said the first time we got married, about the first time that we met.
We have like the same memory, and for some reason this night really ingrained into our memory, but like each other being in it is very fuzzy. That's like the fuzziest part.
Yeah, it's almost like non-existent. I remember, like I said before, I remember this figure and I don't remember anything else. But I remember okay, so let's just get into it. We were at this really popular park in Nashville called Centennial Park, and they have this real live replica of the Parthenon in Greece. And it's really awesome. If you haven't been there, you should come here and visit.
And we were there for Shakespeare in the Park. This happens all over the country, so you might know what it is, but just play in the park, Shakespeare. And we were
bored, I guess.
And so we decided, we both decided just to end up over at the Parthenon.
I was with my friend, Eric, and you were with your friend, Michelle. And we didn't even know that the other person was there. And we didn't, I don't even know if we had cell phones back then. I mean, sure.
No, like, I did not have
I don't think that we did.
No. But Michelle was the link here.
Yeah.
Michelle was my good friend, but then also Jordan's good friend.
At school. And
we didn't know each other.
Well, we decided separately that we were going to go to the Parthenon area of that park.
And we just happened to run into each other.
And somehow we came up with this bright idea, hey, let's play hide and seek on the Parthenon. And it's really cool, obviously, because the Parthenon has these massive columns and just these massive stairs that you can, like, duck under and hide. And there's a million places that you can just be right next to somebody and they would never find you. Which was awesome. You could just dodge between pillars and stuff. And it was really fun. That's why I remember that so well.
Well, and it was like one of those games that you just can't recreate. You can't be like, oh, let's go play that again. Mm-hmm. Because it just was, like, really fun. Yeah, like, I don't even know why.
It was
like,
so spontaneous. Spontaneous.
Yeah.
And I don't know how we came up with it. Anyways, that was like the first time that we met was like me literally tagging you playing this game when we were like kind of too old to be playing.
I feel like I was about 15.
Yeah.
Somewhere around that age. Maybe 16?
We were older. Yeah, I mean, I think I was like 14 And so that would probably made you,
so
like, 16.
So maybe I was, like, 16 or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I don't know. I guess I was too old to be playing with these
random. But it was so much fun. And, like, again, that was one of the most fun memories I can remember, like, playing a game with friends.
Something that's really weird about that night is I actually remember exactly what I was wearing. And I remember you were wearing a hat. And that is all I remember.
I really just don't remember you at all. And it's so weird to look back and just think we made such little impressions on each other. And somehow we were laying in this Helix mattress filming a video on our YouTube channel that we have together. It's really kind of crazy to think back at how little of an impression we made on each other.
Yeah.
Anyway, so that was the first official time that we met.
And I don't even remember, how did we even connect that we were the other ones in that story, in that memory?
Well, I'll tell you this, because I think you were just like the girl on MySpace.
Oh,
and
so
we
add each other.
No, I just remember you, we didn't even add each other on MySpace after that, I don't think. I just remember, like, just kind of knowing, oh, this is that girl. And so I don't remember what you looked like at the park. I just remember connecting, she's her profile picture from there. That was the extent of it. So I knew who you were, I don't remember you.
But then fast forward, however many years, quite a few years, we met again. And this time it stuck.
Yeah, I think it was like 6 years later or something like that. And somehow we ended up at, again, mutual friends, the story of our lives, have basically a ton of mutual friends, but like never actually knew each other. But we met up at the Mellow Mushroom, which is another location in Nashville, and we had dinner together with our friends. And then I was like, oh, hi, did we even connect that we were the same people? We had to have at that point.
I don't know. I really don't remember even what I was thinking. Honestly, I was just excited that I was invited to this dinner because I was not invited to it.
You were excited you were invited to a dinner you weren't invited to.
Well, I got invited very last minute because my brother needed someone to drive him.
Oh, yeah, because he had injured his leg.
Yes, so he had surgery on his knee, and so he needed me to drive him, and that's the only way that I was even there.
I don't think I ever even connected that your brother was, that your brother had a sister, and that sister was the one who was on MySpace, who was the one that I hung out with that time. It was just like you showed up at the restaurant, and it was like, oh.
There were so many, like, web connections here, because actually at the time when we met at the restaurant, I was going to school with both your brother and sister.
Oh, yeah, and you spent time with my brother at the radio station that he kind of basically ran.
And your sister gave me a textbook for one of my first ever freshman classes.
And so then I went to another college, and then after we met, then, and it wasn't because of you that I transferred, but then just the next year I transferred to your school, which was the school that my brother and sister went to. Yeah. And then that's kind of how we became close, very close friends at school. And I mean, if we're being completely honest, we were talking about this earlier today, since then we have basically, almost without fail, I would say maybe, like, give or take, let's say 3 months out of our entire time of knowing each other, which is like, basically 9 years now, we have only not seen each other 3 months out of those, like, consecutive days out of that amount of time. Every other day we've seen each other for nine years. Every single day. We would drive to school, even if the other one was off school, or we would drive to the person's house after school to see each other every single day.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy. All that to say, it just goes to show that you never know who is entering into your life, because if you had told me on that day, however many years ago, that I was going to marry you, I would be like, what?
The person I don't even remember their face.
Yeah. And it's also kind of weird because when you're that young, and a 14 to 16 seems like,
oh, a huge difference. Like, yeah.
When you're in your 20s, it's like no big deal. But I think at the time I'd be like, no.
Yeah. And again, it's just that, again, I've said this before, but you were just that girl on MySpace with the profile picture. And I thought, I wonder where she is in that profile picture. It was like a nice little, like, there was a nice pond there and I had no clue where you were. Now I've been there and we've hung out there together and now we're married. It's just like everything about it is just weird. You just, all these random things just kind of end up tying together. So who knows, maybe you're out there and you're 17 and there's this 14-year-old kid that, you know, and then you guys are going to get older one day and you're going to look at the 14-year-old who's now, you know, 23 and you're going to think, maybe this isn't weird.
Maybe.
Maybe this isn't that weird.
Maybe we'd be like...
Yeah.
Yeah.
You never know. I hope you enjoyed our little walk down memory lane. I kind of wanted just a concise video of this so I could look back on it in my life personally. So anyways, guys, check out Helix. HelixSleep.com/JordanTaylor. Support our sponsor. Support us. It really helps out. Smash that like button. Hit the bell. We love you guys. We'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye.